whatever you wish for, you keep. Have faith in your dreams, and someday your rainbow will come smiling through. No matter how your heart is grieving, if you keep on believing, the dreams that you wish will come true. So this is love. So this is love. So this is what makes life divine. My heart has wings, and I can fly. I'll touch every star in the sky. No matter how your heart is screaming, that you wish will come true. A dream that I wish will come true. No matter how your heart is grieving, if you keep on believing, the dreams that you wish will come true.
Welcome back to Disney Movie Stack. I'm your host, Ray Gootz, and I am here with Camille Theobald. Camille, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good because finally on this podcast, I'm out of the dark ages of shitty Disney films, and I'm back into the classics because we had just watched Cinderella.
Mm-hmm.
But before we get into Cinderella and our thoughts about this movie and all sorts of things, Camille, how long have you been doing stand-up comedy?
About 8 years. I would say the first 4 years I was doing like a lot of other stuff, so I wasn't doing as much stand up, but I was still doing it at least once or twice a week. So I don't know. Can you count it as a full those years? Who knows? And I would say eight-ish.
Okay. But you were, but the first couple of years you were part time.
Hard. Yeah.
Yeah. When did you start going hard?
I started going hard 4 years in. So we could count the first 4 years as 2 years or something.
So, because I first saw you in 2016.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I started in 2011, 2010. My first like open mic was 2010.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
And what made you want to get into stand-up?
I liked being funny in general. I was always a goofball, but I thought I wanted to be like the sexy dancer, singer, so I went to...
Yeah, you dance, right?
I used to, yeah.
Okay, yeah, yeah, okay.
So I went to musical theater. I wanted to be like, you know, J-Lo or Britney Spears, someone like who danced and then sang, and all my teachers were like, yeah, that's not you, so maybe you should like do stuff that you are actually right for. And eventually I listened and I was like, oh yeah, being funny is way easier than trying to be sexy. So yeah, that's kind of how it started. And then I like tried everything. I tried improv and sketch and stand up all at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And I was still trying to dance as well on top of that.
Oh wow.
So like that's why I kind of was spread thin at the beginning, because I choreographed a musical and then I was like, yeah, that's the last time I'm going to dance. And then, but I was all doing it all at the same time.
You're still doing improv and the stand up.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. So you choreographed a musical?
Yeah. Like a brand new musical. A friend of mine wrote it.
Oh, wow.
About a black girl who grew up thinking she was white. Like her parents lied to her. It's very,
so
it's
she never
comical.
Saw a mirror?
The mirrors are all like, yeah, they're either hidden from her, mm-hmm, or there's one mirror and they actually have someone on the other end imitating all our movements.
Oh,
it's
wow.
Like a ridiculous, you know, it's a suspending your belief type musical.
Oh,
but
wow.
Yeah.
Okay. That's crazy. All right.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's insane. And when did you start dancing? How old were you?
I was 13.
Oh,
maybe
okay.
Younger.
So you did it for like 12, a while.
Yeah, I danced till I was like 21, 22. I thought, you know, I'd be on cruise ships dancing and singing and stuff, but I'm not tall enough really to do a lot of the cruise ships or a lot of like chorus dancing or anything in musicals. Because I'm short, I would have to be doing specific dancing, which I was like, that's not going to make any money. So,
yeah.
And I always just felt shitty about my body.
Oh, really? When you're a dancer?
Yeah.
Well, I know, that's what I feel like. I noticed that because I went to Marymount. Did you go to college?
Yeah, I went to a 2-year acting conservatory.
Oh, okay. I went to Marymount Manhattan College, which has a really, I mean, at the time it had a very, they thought they were so fucking amazing.
yeah, dance program. Yeah. Marymount.
And it's so funny. Jasmine is like, I'm trying to get her not. Jasmine's on top of me, everybody, and I'm trying to get her not touch the laptop.
And she's like,
she's like balancing herself on. Come on, but you remind me actually of one of the first girls I met in college, and she was always very like body conscious and freaking out about what she ate. And the first time she went out drinking, she was like freaking out that it was going to ruin her body and all this stuff. Man. And I don't know what happened to her, but her boyfriend was ugly. That's what I do remember. she wasn't bad looking. Sad. But no. What?
That her boyfriend was ugly.
Yeah, no. I think he had. God, maybe I'm remembering my history teacher. I'm like, he looked a lot like my history teacher. I'm remembering my history teacher, not her actual boyfriend. But who knows? I don't know where she is. I can't remember her name at this point. But she was like my first female friend in college. But I don't know where she is.
Yeah.
And let me ask you a question. Where did you grow up?
Salt Lake City, Utah, till I was 14.
And then where'd you guys move?
Then I moved. My mom stayed in Utah, and I moved with my dad in Colorado.
Okay. And how long were you in Colorado?
Until I was 18, so like 4 years.
And then you came here?
And then I moved to New York, yeah.
Oh, wow. So that's crazy. You were 18 on your own in New York?
My sister did move here as well.
Oh, okay. That's
my big sister.
Sorry, you have a sister. I forgot.
Yeah,
How was your childhood, though?
Well, how was my childhood? It was a little fucked up.
Oh, okay.
I mean, the reason why I had to move in with my dad when I was 13 is because my mom had attempted suicide.
Oh, wow.
So,
sorry.
It was like the third time or something, and then she tried more after that. So after
so
a
they
while,
got the date when after divorce things like that.
They got
happened?
Divorced like the month I was born.
Oh, so, wow.
Yeah. I never knew them to be together.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
So yeah, the concept of them not being together was never an issue. Mm-hmm. And so movies were my escape. Performing was my escape, dancing, singing. Those were my things, like, to sort of, you know, forget that we didn't really have a lot at home and stuff. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So you mentioned movies to your escape. Were you big into Disney movies as a kid? Or cartoon movies?
Oh, my gosh. Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like, okay. My favorite was Little Mermaid.
Okay,
I used to call it Mermaid.
Mermaid, okay.
Like, my dad, whenever I'd sleep, I would see him every other weekend. Mm-hmm. And, like, my go-to was, like, Dad, can I watch Little Mermaid? And I guess it was the only way he could get me to go to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
So I watched it a lot.
Okay.
And then when Lion King came out, that was the next thing.
Okay, what about Beauty and the Beast and Aladdin? Were you into those?
I was into Aladdin and Beauty and the Beast, yes. For some reason, Little Mermaid and Lion King were the ones that stuck the most.
Yeah, that's so funny. You know, right now, I still haven't seen Lion King.
Yeah. What?
That's the next thing I have to watch. I've been meaning to watch it all week, and then because I'm going to Mexico tomorrow, things keep getting in the way.
Yeah.
But I saw up to when Mustafa.
Mm-hmm.
Mustafa dies. And okay. I saw it in high school. They just put it on for an assembly.
Yeah.
And then the bell rang. We all just had to leave.
Oh.
And I never got to what happens after Mustafa dies.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. I bawled every single time. Even though I knew it was going to happen, I bawled.
Did you see the live action version?
Yes.
Did you cry?
I loved it. I cried. Yeah.
You cried? Okay, cool. Did you see it with Sheba Mason? Or did I imagine that? No, right?
No.
Because I know she saw it with a bunch of comedians.
Oh, okay.
Okay, I could have swore she said you were one of them. Maybe not. Maybe it was some other female comic.
Possible.
So, yeah. Did you ever see Cinderella when you were younger?
Yes, of course.
Okay, and what did you think of it back then?
I remember thinking Cinderella was really pretty, and that I loved that, like, since I was, like, poor as a kid, I loved that the poor girl, like, got the guy, you know?
Yeah.
So that was, like, sort of a little fantasy of, like, oh, well, I may not have Abercrombie, but I'll get the guy in the end, you know?
Yeah, yeah, that's true. Well, we Abercrombie was the big thing back then.
Oh yeah, Abercrombie, aerosol. Oh, American Eagle was really big in my junior high.
Wow, that's so funny.
Yeah,
it was. Yeah, when but when I what year were you in junior high?
So 2001 to 2003, I guess.
Okay. It's so funny because that's when I was in college and I had a kid. Again, this is relating to college. I had a kid who would buy all that Abercrombie and Fitch, Prada,
yeah.
American Eagle. And I was just, and he was from like the suburbs of Jersey. And mm-hmm. I know he still buys Prada now. And I'm like, what the fuck? I don't even know what the fuck this shit is about. Because here at Astoria, people were all about starter jackets and Jordans.
Yeah.
And they weren't into that other crap. That you guys
yeah,
were into.
I didn't even know what Jordans were.
Oh, really? Okay.
Until I moved to New York City.
Team of New York, and everyone was
and
like,
I was like, oh, Michael Jordan shoes? Okay.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't know it was a big deal at all.
Oh, massive.
I knew people wore them to play basketball. That was it.
Yeah, no, yeah, they wear them now to weddings.
Yeah.
Okay. Every all types of crap.
Total cultural difference.
So, now that you're an adult, what'd you think of the movie now that you're watching it, rewatching it now?
So, as I grew older, mm-hmm. I started... even like when I was a teenager, I was like, kind of thought how silly it was that Cinderella just like, all right, well, this man will fix all my problems.
Yeah.
and so I never really liked that part of it. Mm-hmm. I did, as a kid, I did love, like, I had a stepmom mm-hmm. and me and her are friends now, but when I was a kid, I hated
like
her.
Was
yeah.
it a lot like this?
Yeah.
Well, she didn't make you do chores. So.
Yes, I did chores every
Sunday.
Oh,
she made you do chores?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
But so my dad would always slip me a 20.
Okay.
You know,
but
my
she
dad
was like, she has to do chores.
Yeah. He oh, was wow. like, you have to do chores. Everyone's doing chores on Sunday or whatever. And I would always do the most of the cleaning. And my dad would joke around and call me Cinderella. and so I definitely like... related to her in a lot of those ways, but I think later I was like, oh, she's not as badass as I thought she was, you know, not as much as Pocahontas or Mulan. Like, those are badass princesses.
Yeah.
So this, I mean, it's very classic. It came out in 1950, so yeah, that was the fantasy of just like, oh, I'll marry a man and he'll be rich and successful and all my problems will be gone and we'll just have kids and that'll be great. You know, it's cute. It's a classic. You can't hate it.
Yeah. See, to me, I think this is still in my top five of Disney films.
Yeah.
I really like the animation, the music.
Yeah.
This is like the rare film. Like, you know, like this is, you know, I guess you could say this is a girl movie,
mm-hmm.
but I feel like this is one of the rare girl movies that I feel like a guy can sit and watch, and there's always something new to find in the movie.
Yeah,
you know, because I feel like a lot of like, even like Frozen. Have you seen Frozen?
Yeah.
What do you think of that?
I thought it was really cute. I loved the sister so much.
Yes, the sisters are cool.
Not Elsa. What's the
Anna? Anna.
Anna, yeah, she was my favorite. I was like, fuck Elsa, I don't care about Elsa. I
yeah,
love
Elsa's
Anna.
Elsa's kind of sucks. She kind of doesn't do shit. But I do feel like that movie like is more geared towards little girls.
Yeah.
Like they're clearly going to get every dollar they can out of every little girl.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas this movie I feel like is more about everybody, mm-hmm. this film.
Mm-hmm.
So I really dig the shit out of it. The one thing I like about this movie is that, you know, the one misconception I think a lot of people have is that Cinderella doesn't do a lot.
Mm-hmm.
But I think she's very proactive in this movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, yeah. you know, I mean, like,
she's
not...
She's trying to get her chores done.
Yeah, she's not like, you know, obviously if this movie was made nowadays, she would told the stepmom to fuck off probably halfway through the film.
Yeah, yeah.
Told the prince, I'm not a sex object, you need to get to know me.
Yeah.
But at the same time, she's like, you know, she's trying to get her work done. She's mm-hmm. going to stepmom, I want to go to the ball.
Mm-hmm.
The only time she's really not proactive is when, like, the fairy godmother shows up and helps her.
Yeah.
But I think that's a powerful scene because you have a character, and I think this is the whole crux of Disney World, Disneyland.
Mm-hmm.
You have a character saying, there's no hope. Mm. There's no use in dreaming. There's no use in hoping for anything to get better. That's what Cinderella's sitting there saying.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden the fairy godmother shows up and just works out everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like that's what Disney is constantly selling people.
Yeah.
You know, like, no, there is hope. If it's if you spend all your money on us.
Yeah.
And you'll be happy again. Yeah.
Yeah, like someone will come and save you. Just work hard enough.
Just work hard enough and go to Disney World, stand on that line, and you'll find happiness.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's what I kind of feel like the whole crux of Disney is, like, you know, the for somebody finds love and shit. And the other thing is proactive, she's directing the animals on what to do so she can get out and meet the guy, these doggies.
Yeah.
Sorry. They're fighting over, the dogs are fighting over Camille's attention right now.
They are.
They went in the other room to duke it out. You know, she's directing the animals on what to do so she can get out and talk to the Duke about her her slippers.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what did you think of the songs? Since you're like, now, I didn't realize how big you were in the music and dancing. What did you think of the songs at this point?
Yeah. They are fun.
Mm-hmm.
Her voice is obviously beautiful. They're not as fun to sing.
No, they're not.
To like sing along with. But they're
they stick in your head.
Yeah, yeah. They do stick in your head. They're very catchy.
Well, there's only three songs. No, there's four, but they didn't put it. The mm-hmm. Nightingale song, which people kind of forget about.
Yeah.
That's a song.
Yeah.
My
favorite is definitely the beginning. The first
A Dream
one.
Is Your Wish?
The first one where she's getting ready with the birds.
Yes, A Dream is Wish Your Heart Makes. Yeah. This movie is pretty significant because in the past, they would just write music in-house with their production company, and then they would have someone else publish the music. And then Disney was like, you know, I should fucking make money off this music if everyone's going to buy the single.
Mm-hmm.
So this was the first time they hired outside composers to make this like a real musical.
Wow.
And this is also the first time they opened up their own, they make their own music division where they start the Walt Disney Music Company. So he would get all the money. Mm-hmm. From when they sold, you know, the singles or the album, the CD and stuff, the record back then, So I thought that was pretty significant. Like, this is the first time he's like, we're making a musical and I want to make money off it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think about that. What's after Cinderella?
Alice in Wonderland was what he was working. That was the big one he wanted to do for years and years. And
yeah.
When was the last time you saw Pinocchio?
Oh, probably like 10 years ago.
Okay, well, the beginning of Pinocchio, and I just noticed this when I watched it for this podcast, there's two books next to Jiminy Cricket, Peter Pan and Alice in Wonderland. And that's Kim kind of saying to people, this is what I'm doing next.
Yeah.
And then World War II broke out. He couldn't get, and they cut off the distribution to Europe,
mm-hmm.
so he couldn't make Alice in Wonderland and Peter Pan like he wanted to.
Mm.
So he had to make like all these weird movies, which is what the last 6 weeks of the podcast were about. And then he starts doing Alice in Wonderland. That's his thing. I got to get Alice in Wonderland out. But it's not progressing well. And this started progressing really fast.
Mm.
And then he decided to make live action. This is also around the time they started making like live action films, which is the first one is Treasure Island.
Yeah.
Which I'm not going to cover because it's about animation. But have you ever seen that movie?
I have, yeah.
Yeah. Did you like it? I liked it when I was like very little.
Yeah. I remember being like, okay.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it was, it's like, it's funny, the live action stuff, and I'm wondering how it's going to hold up, because are you going to get Disney Plus next week?
I am not, but my boyfriend is, so basically I'll get
it. So you'll have it, yeah. You'll have the password, okay.
Yeah.
Although Disney's going to try, because Disney's a motherfucker, they're going to try to make sure you can't share the password.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, I'll probably watch it at his house anyway.
But I'm wondering how many of these old live action movies that they did come out?
Yeah.
And how they hold up, because nobody really talks a lot about Disney's live action films from the 50s, except for like Parent Trap.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. What do you think of the character design and animation?
So I think all the bad people they had so much detail. Or mm-hmm. again, the dad. The dad's not necessarily a bad guy, but he's definitely handsy with all of his people.
Yes.
And a schemer.
Yeah.
he's like a Jewish mother. But for some reason, it seems like Cinderella has like no features other than like nostril holes,
mm-hmm.
eyes, and then kind of lips.
And like it's very weird. Young womanly body. Not a womanly body.
No, like a 14-year-old
body. 14-year-old woman's body. Yeah. Yeah.
Which is fine. I don't need animated boobs.
You don't need
anything.
Her to have jiggles.
No,
she doesn't have to
not.
Jiggle when she runs. But at the same time, it's like, I was saying this off air. Disney, like you could tell watching these movies, had a very specific mind of what like a good woman's body should be.
Yeah.
You know?
Skinny.
Yeah. No, like the butt doesn't stick out. The yeah. breasts don't stick out. The hips yeah. don't stick out. Like just very pretty face. Mm-hmm. And that's about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd say, I mean, if we're going to go off trying to be realistic, I guess like Cinderella would be like a little emaciated. You know, she probably doesn't eat that well. Mm-hmm. She works all the time.
Yeah.
But the sister should be fat.
Yeah. I think the best animated character in this, I used to always think it was the mice when I was a kid. But mm-hmm. now that I'm older and I'm like learning more about animation, I thought the mom, stepmom, yeah. is so well animated. Doesn't she remind you of B. Arthur a lot?
Yes. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Yes. Mm-hmm.
It's so funny because I kind of like thought to myself, man, what if I did B. Arthur do the voice? And she didn't. It was just some woman, the older woman. But
yeah,
I thought she was fantastic.
The animation was great for her.
Yeah, definitely. And the mice are wonderfully animated.
Oh, yeah.
The cat. I like the king. Although the king's relationship with the duke is really fucking weird. Like, why is it his assistant's fault? If his son doesn't want to... Let me tell you something.
Yeah.
If my dad had an assistant, and that assistant was going to die if I didn't get laid by the time I was like 20, 22...
That guy
would
have died.
That guy would be in the fucking grave.
Hilarious.
That guy would have got his head chopped off.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, I felt bad for that guy because he was just like, come on, I don't want to die.
Yeah, will you please somebody fuck this guy?
Yeah. Like running after her. Oh, like, hey,
please come back. I really like this movie. I think it holds up. I don't. Is there anything here you think doesn't hold up or is like kind of out of date or anything?
I was actually pretty impressed with the, you know, the castle.
Yes. Well, that's the castle now they use for Disney World.
Yeah. And like the pumpkin carriage and stuff. That was all like really cool. I was impressed with like how they were able to do that with such little, you know, they didn't have a lot.
Yeah, they just basically were hand drawing stuff. And this was the first movie. They didn't make a full-length movie. All the other movies kind of had like different segments and stuff. Mm-hmm. This is the first full-length movie since Bambi.
Wow.
Which was a bomb. This was not a bomb. This was a huge hit.
Mm-hmm. Bambi was a bomb?
Yeah, when it first came out, it was a bomb. Yeah.
Wow.
A lot of movies that we love now were like massive bombs. Like Christmas Story was a bomb. What else is like a movie that everybody loves now? Oh, Hocus Pocus was a huge bomb.
Really?
Yeah. I remember when it came out, it didn't even make the top 10 like of that week.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
So like, it's funny like... Just the life other movies can take on afterwards. Mm-hmm. And then there's like movies that nobody remembers that were massive hits. I'm trying to think. No, see, I don't remember. So
That's why.
Yeah.
We forgot.
Yeah, I forgot about it.
Okay, what doesn't take that? I mean, I think it's hilarious that the prince doesn't talk at all.
Yes. I'd always assumed that he had a few lines.
Yeah.
Oh, he does sing.
Oh, yeah, he does sing.
Okay, but he doesn't say a goddamn word.
No.
He's silent. Mm-hmm. And the funny thing is, like, there's a whole scene where the king and his, like, assistant are talking about, you know, that she got away. Mm-hmm. How are we going to find this woman? And the prince's desires. And I'm like, why isn't the prince in that room telling his dad, I want to... And also, why isn't the prince out there looking for this woman? Why is he sending... I'm in love. Let me tell you something. I've been in love with girls before. I'm not sending my dad's assistant out to go find them.
Yeah. Oh, you know what doesn't hold up? Because after living in New York for a while, thinking about mice fixing my dress just grosses me out.
Yes.
I'm like, oh, I'm going to have like a bunch of holes eaten through my dress. No, thank you.
Oh, yeah. Matt, the prince, when he's like, oh, my true love. She's like, listen, I have these mice that we got to dress up and live with us. And he's just like, what?
I got them all outfits.
Yeah, I got them outfits. We're going to have them wedding outfits. They kind of helped me out. They built my other dress. Like, just like, you know, that's what happens when you don't really talk to a girl. You realize she has mental problems down the road. You're like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
I rushed into this.
When you don't have an actual conversation, you realize, oh, she talks to herself.
It's funny. All my friends who rush into relationships then will tell me months later, this person's kind of crazy. And I'm like, yeah, you declared your love for them 2 weeks in.
Yeah.
What did you think was going to happen? Like,
yeah.
You don't really even know them. And like, oh, yeah, they're crazy. But, you know, Disney, Every time someone meets someone, they fall in love within seconds. So
totally. Yeah. And I feel like back then that was the dream.
Yeah.
Wasn't it? Just like, when you know, you know. That's what everyone would say.
People got married earlier, too, back then.
Yeah.
And if, like, how old are you right now?
30.
Okay. I'm 38. We would have been, like, outcasts in 1940, 1950 society.
Yeah.
They would have been, like, I mean, like,
I'm
even
a shrew
in the
or something.
Oh, yeah. Even in the 70s, my mom's friends thought that there was something wrong with her and my dad because they didn't have kids. They didn't want kids.
Mm-hmm.
And they were married for 20 years before they had me. But there was, like, why don't you want kids? Like, even in the 70s. Like, what
Jeez.
Is. Yeah. And, well, you know, I guess God showed her. I guess God showed her.
She got pregnant. She's like, well, I guess we'll keep it.
Yeah. I guess we'll be doing a Disney podcast in 38 years. Whatever. all right. So let me ask you a quick question. Do you ever plan on having children?
I've thought about it. Mm-hmm. I think I might have one, but I'm not really planning it. You know? If it seems convenient, sure.
Okay. The reason why I asked that is, if you ever do have children, would you show them this film?
Probably not.
Really? You're like, no.
Nah. I mean, maybe, just to be like, hey, I need to do something. Watch this, you know?
We could have Disney Plus by then.
Oh, yeah. So yeah. I guess they should watch the trilogy. But I really do not like Snow White. So
I don't think that holds up. The reason why I like Snow White is because it was the first one,
mm-hmm.
and it changes the animation industry.
Yeah, totally.
But I can't sit and watch it.
Mm-mm.
And what's the other one you don't like?
What's her name? With the hair down, let your
Tangled?
Hair. Oh wait, no. She's surrounded by a. It's an A name. She's surrounded by a dragon. She's stuck in a castle.
Sleeping Beauty. I don't like that one at all.
Yeah, I don't like Sleeping Beauty either.
That one's really bad. I feel like every shitty stereotype of Disney films comes from that movie.
Yeah.
You know?
Definitely.
Yeah, I do not like that movie at
all. Yeah. So those two.
Those two. All right. Mm-hmm. I don't like Sleeping Beauty, and I don't like Fantasia. Do you like Fantasia?
It's weird. I think it's great for, like, doing drugs and watching.
Okay.
Like, get high and watch Fantasia, and you will be like, what the fuck? Yeah.
Okay.
It's a great one for that. But otherwise, it's, like, hard to watch, because you're just like, okay, so what's happening? What's the storyline here? What? Yeah.
That's funny. Whatchamacallit, the one I think that everybody started doing drugs is actually, and this is why I'm having my next guest, is Alice in Wonderland. They used to show that at nightclubs
in New
York in the 70s.
Yeah.
And people would do drugs to it.
Mm-hmm.
And Katherine Henson is going to be the guest.
Yes.
Talk about drug use and Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah.
So that's the one I think is very big on druggies. What's your favorite Disney film? Oh, you said it, Little Mermaid. So we didn't even ask you that.
Well, like, not anymore.
Oh, what's your favorite one now?
Because now, like, after, you know, Mulan came out and all that, I was like, dang. Like, I thought Little Mermaid was, like, the shit. But now I realize she gave up all of her talents for a dude.
Yeah.
She literally gave up everything for this guy. Screw that. I don't like that. I would say to date, my favorite would be, it's either Mulan or I really actually liked Princess and the Frog.
Okay. I haven't seen one of them yet.
It's so cute.
Okay.
Yeah.
My mom liked Princess and the Frog.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was good. And Mulan, my mom, but I know Mike Racine loves Mulan. He actually asked you that episode.
Nice.
Yeah. And Christina likes Mulan. And Chewie May, like, you know Chewie?
Of course.
Yeah, she likes Mulan. So that's a pretty pop. And they're doing the remake, but I always feel like these live action remakes, they got to have the goofy little character.
They do.
Like, oh, it's not realistic. Well, I'm sorry, but none of this shit is realistic, all right?
Yeah, the whole freaking thing isn't.
Like, they didn't have Gilbert Godfrey in the remake of Aladdin. They just had, like, a parrot voice.
Wow.
And when they asked him, why no Gilbert Godfrey, like, well, it's not really realistic to have a parrot with a Jewish voice. And I'm like, oh, but a blue Will Smith is realistic. A genie that can cast spells is realistic.
Yeah, I haven't seen it. They don't have that in, they don't even have a monkey in the musical for Aladdin.
Oh, there's no Abu?
The Broadway musical, there's no Abu. He just has three friends.
Oh, yeah. Well, that was the original script was three friends.
I was like, where is, I need Abu.
Wow. Yeah, he has three. What did the three friends do? They just hang out.
They do all the parts that Abu would have done. You know how Abu like helped him escape at some point and stuff like that? That's what they do.
So he says three guys that hang around him.
Basically, like they help him scheme. They're like all the schemers together. They would figure out how to make money and steal and stuff together.
Ugh.
I know.
Good thing I never saw that. It's very, very disappointing.
I mean, it's a good musical, but yeah, I was a little upset at that there was no Abu.
I would be upset about that too.
Yeah, that's just like having Cinderella with no mice.
I think that's what happens in live action.
Can't do that.
That's why I kind of want to watch the live action version with Richard Madden because I'm really, I don't want to see Cinderella. What does she do? Talk to the wall? Like what? They must have given her a friend or something.
Somebody.
Because she has to explain herself to someone.
At least a dog. Like, at least get. Because the cat played such a huge role in this.
Mm-hmm.
For them to not have cats, a cat, I mean, I don't know. It's crazy.
So, this episode's probably going to come out in December. Do you have anything you want to plug?
Ooh. Well, January 28th, I have my Caroline's Breakout Artist series. So, I realize that's the month after, but plan ahead. January 28th, 7:30 p.m. at Caroline's on Broadway.
So cool. Wow.
Yeah.
You excited?
I'm excited.
All right, good.
Yeah.
And you're going to be. How much time are you going to do?
45.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. I did it past summer in Utah to like all my family and they laughed. They were able to laugh at all my jokes about them. So I think it'll be okay. I think it'll go well.
All right, cool. I'm excited about that. Yeah. And what was I going to ask you? Sorry, I had one more question to ask you. How can people find you on social media?
Yeah. Camille Theobald, CamilleTheobald. .com.
Okay.
Or on Instagram, Camille Theobald Comedy.
Mm-hmm.
Or on Twitter, Camel Theo, CamilleTheo.
Oh, so it's a different name on
But honestly, my name's not that common. So if you just Googled it, you'd find all this shit.
Yes. Do you update Twitter a lot or no?
With shows and stuff, and I'll try to be good about posting jokes, but I'm so bad at it.
Yeah, me too. I hate Twitter too. I constantly get into fights on Twitter.
Yeah.
It's just people looking to tell you that you're wrong, but anything.
Totally.
You'd be like, I love my mom. Actually, your mom was kind of a bitch. Like, I don't know. Like, actually, your mom's been canceled.
Yeah.
And it's like, all right, guys on Twitter. But you're really funny on Instagram.
Oh, thank you.
You post a lot on Instagram.
I do. Yeah, that's my main thing is Instagram. All my Elizabeth Warren videos.
Yeah, so if you like to make fun of Elizabeth Warren.
Yeah.
Camille's your girl. So, but definitely follow on Instagram. 100% I recommend on that.
Thank you.
And that's it. Thank you so much for being on this episode.
Yeah. Thank you for having me and bringing me back to my childhood.
No problem. And sorry, got a little dark, but hey, you know,
hey.
That's your journey.
That's my journey. I don't mind telling
you. And it brought you to Cinderella.
It did.
Brought
you
back.
She gave me hope.
Yeah. Your dream is what your heart makes.
She showed me that my dreams could come true. As long as a magic fairy arrives.
Yeah. Can't do it on your own.
Yeah.
Gotta have someone just show up and just make it all happen. I feel like that's how half people treat comedy.
Totally.
How come I'm not famous yet?
Yeah.
Where's my fairy godmother?
Yep.
Thank you so much for listening, guys. Next week will be Alice in Wonderland with Katherine Henson. And we'll see you then. Camille, thank you for your time.
Yeah.
And I'll talk to you guys later. Peace out.
Awesome.